Ya Allah, please forgive me for the wrong I've done. Ya Allah, give me another chance to prove that I can pass. Please guide me and protect me along the straight path. And I know that I can make it one day. I'll be in heaven with you.
When the Muslims conquered a certain city in Iran, the companions and certain Muslims started to speak about the fact that the Dajjal had appeared. And one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sa'ab radiyallahu anhu, said, "You should not say this, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam informed me of something that if I tell you about it, you will not say what you're saying." And he went on to relate the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, related by Imam Ahmad and considered to be Sahih by Ibn Ma'in, that the Dajjal will not appear until people stop speaking about him. وَحَتَّى يَتْرُكُ الْعِمَّةُ ذِكْرُهَا عَلَى الْمَنَابِرِ, and until the scholars on the minbar, on the Friday prayer, stop mentioning the Dajjal. And at that point, the people who were there stopped speaking about the fact that the Dajjal had appeared. And that hadith is a very interesting hadith, because I just went to Umrah just a couple of weeks ago, and one of the things that struck me about the pilgrimage, the smaller pilgrimage, the Umrah, is the fact that many of the things that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said will come are happening in a way that is almost unbelievable. When I was in Madinah Munawwara, I went with one of the scholars of the city who works in editing books of fiqh, and he took me to a place called Jurf. And this is a place just outside the city of Madinah Munawwara. And this place is mentioned by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in relation to Dajjal. He said that Dajjal will come to the eastern part of Madinah Munawwara, will be unable to enter into the city, and will try and come over the northern side of the city of Madinah Munawwara, and then he will set up camp in Sabqat al-Jurf. This is a desolate place just outside Madinah Munawwara, a place which the scholars said until 15 years ago nobody would have the audacity to build upon, because of the fact that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned it as a place where the Dajjal would come and trying to enter the city of Madinah Munawwara will not be able to do it, and he will set up camp there. فَتَرْتَجِفُ الْمَدِينَةُ ثَلَاثَ رَجَفَاتٍ, and when he sets up his camp there, Madinah Munawwara will shake three times. فَيَخْرُجُ إِلَيْهِ كُلُّ مُنَافِقٍ وَمُنَافِقَةٍ, and every single munafiq in the city of Madinah Munawwara will come out of the city, and every female munafiq will come out of the city. وَفَاسِقْ وَفَاسِقَ, and even people that are irreligious will come out of the city of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that is Yawm al-Khalas. This is a day in which the city of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will be rid of all of the dirt that is contained within it. When I saw people building, he said, this is one of the signs that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what he said is true. And the hadith related by Imam Ahmad radiyallahu anhu says that the Dajjal will climb upon a mountain there and will look upon the city of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, will be unable to enter the city because angels will be protecting it, and he will say, "Hadha qasru Ahmad." He will see a building in the distance and he will say, "This is the palace of Ahmad." And in a narration, "Hadha masjidu Ahmada." This is the mosque of Ahmad. And it's interesting that he will say it's a white palace. Whereas the time the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we knew his mosque alayhi salatu wasalam was so pious that he would use palm leaves and mud and cane to create the mosque, a small mosque. And now if you see the mosque of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you can actually see it from space as a massive white building. But the interesting thing is that people are forgetting that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came when the Day of Judgment was like the two fingers of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I was sent, and the Day of Judgment is like these two fingers. This is why in the Quran Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly reminds us of the fact, azifatil azifa, that the thing that is close has come closer. An amazing man, Baydawi radiallahu anhu, he says that this verse of the Quran shows the amazing quality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the Day of Judgment as being close already, and the thing that is close has come closer and it's past. And our lives are lived in a way that is totally neglectful and totally irresponsible of the fact that these things are happening in our day. And when I went to Mecca al-Mukarramah, the signs became even more clear. When you go to Makkah al-Mukarramah, you see the most amazing things that the Prophet informed us would happen. In one of the hadiths, Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As radiallahu anhu was on his camel, and one of his followers, one of the tabi'een, took his camel and started to walk towards the Makkah al-Mukarramah. He was going towards Makkah al-Mukarramah. And he said to them, "What will you do on the day that you destroy the Kaaba?" And they said, "Will we destroy the Kaaba?" And he says, "You will destroy the Kaaba." Until La Hadrun ala Hadr, and he said, until there will be no stone on the of the Kaaba, on another stone of the Kaaba will be totally destroyed. And they said to him, "Will we be Muslims on that day?" And he says, "Yes, we'll be Muslims." And then you will build it even better than it was ever created in the history of the earth. And then you will see people. رأيت المكة بعجت كظائمة. And you will see the city of Mecca al-Mukarramah being pierced with tunnels. And when Ibn Athir mentioned this hadith, and he mentioned what kaza'im means, he said it means wells. And the wells will go down, and they will dig so many wells in the city of Mecca al-Mukarramah that they'll come together under the ground, and they'll come to surface somewhere else. When I was reading this hadith, one of the scholars of the contemporary scholars of hadith, Muhammad ibn Awama radiallahu anhu, one of the scholars in fact who lives in Madinatul Munawwarah at this time, one of the great muhaddith of this age, in his edition of Ibn Abi Shaybah, he says Ibn Athir was trying to think of what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam meant by this hadith. What could qada'im mean? At his time he thought it was wells, but if you look at Mecca al-Mukarramah now, and when we were going to perform Umrah, going to Masjid Aisha, I thought we were going all through the old route towards Masjid Aisha, to Tan'im. But what we did is went straight through a tunnel. And when we came back, we came through another tunnel. The whole of the city of Mecca al-Mukarramah is punctuated with tunnels. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this hadith related by Ibn Abi Shaybah, which is sahih, he said that Mecca al-Mukarramah will be pierced with tunnels. And not only that, وَرَأَيْتَ الْبِنَاءَ تَعْلُو جِبَالَهَا أَوْ رَأُوسَ جِبَالِهَا. And you will see the buildings of Mecca al-Mukarramah far exceeding the peaks of the mountains of the city of Mecca al-Mukarramah. If you go to the city now, you will see nothing but that sign. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in one hadith mentioned such amazing things that at that time they could not even imagine what they meant. But people are totally heedless of the fact that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to give them knowledge of the fact that the signs are coming closer and closer. He says, فَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ ذَلِكَ فَقَدْ فَإِنَّ الْأَمْرَ قَدْ أَظَلَّكَ. And he said, if this is happening, you see this, then know that the appointed time has cast a shadow on you. You know, when somebody tells you somebody's close to you, and you say, where is he? He's close. But at the moment that he cast a shadow on your body, you know that person is right next to you. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, when you see these signs, then know that the final hour has cast its shadow over you. But we are in complete negligence of this, heedlessness of this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly tells us of the fact that ghafla is the thing that will lead us astray. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, اقترب للناس حسابهم وهم في غفلة معرضون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the final hour and the people's judgment is coming closer to them. اقترب للناس حسابهم. Your judgment, not my judgment, your judgment is coming closer and closer. اقترب is coming closer, constantly, day by day. Every breath that you take, it comes closer and closer. وَهُمْ فِي غَفْلَةٍ مُعْرِضُونَ. But how do people react? How do we react? We turn away in heedlessness. That's the reality of it. Even in the West, where we have so many issues, there's so many things to talk about, so many political issues to talk about, so many social issues to talk about. But the reality of our faith is that our prayer and our fasting, all this is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as Imam Junaid al-Baghdadi radiallahu anhu said, what is life except 5 prayers and waiting for death? What else is it? You wake up, you go to work, you earn money, you spend it. You become a day older, the next day you wake up, the same thing. And all you do in that day that will bring you Felicity in the hereafter is praying five times a day. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly warns us of the fact that this quality of ghafla, heedlessness, is the thing that will be our downfall. The signs that we see around us, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned to us of the Day of Judgment, coming closer and closer, are coming closer and closer. Even more than the people before us realized that they were coming closer, they're coming closer. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we turn to Allah in tawbah, in istighfar, in rujur. And we listen to the words of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as they should be listened to. And we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He protects us from the fitna of Dajjal, and He protects us from the fitna of the qabr, and He protects us from the fitna of this life and the hereafter. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
I wonder if I've been good today. Didn't you know about it? So why am I afraid to pass away? Someday a spark that fire, I'm a star.